gonna build a mountain from a little hill.
Hey guys, and thank you so much for tuning into my channel. My name is The Lay Designer, and we are back with another speedboat video of our city zoo. And in this episode, we are going to build a habitat for the beautiful moose. This habitat is located right next to the South American Dome and the walk-in habitat that we built in the previous episode. So if you have not seen that one yet, I highly recommend you to watch that one. I'm really happy with how that one has turned out. So yeah, definitely go and check that one out if you haven't yet. So for this area, I wanted to try and see if we could make a big, really shaped lake going through basically the whole North American area that we are working on right now. So what I basically did was like drawing out the area where I wanted to have the lake with like some walls. This is not really in the recording because the video was gonna be super long, so I did cut that out. But I made a blueprint out of those walls and went to like this empty files or a new empty map to do some terraforming, because this file is pretty big. So doing some terraforming may actually take some more time because of the lag and stuff. So I thought it was just easier to use an empty map instead. So I drew out like this layout of like a river or a lake, whatever you want to call it, and then made like this habitat blueprint out of it so I could put it back into City Zoo, and it would save me a little bit of frustrations and slow lag when building it completely myself in this map. And it did work out pretty easily, I do have to say. And obviously we're going to adjust it a little bit more, like it's not completely how it is going to be in the end, but we definitely have like this basic, so I think this definitely is something that we can work with. So once we laid out the lake, it was obviously time to add the habitat for the moose. So the path around the habitat, I wanted to have this more raised with a combination of more floating path and a bridge and more path that was more closely to the terrain. So there will be a bit of variation in there. And on one side, there is going to be like this staircase going up. And on the other side, there's more of like this sloped ramp, if we can call it that way. So yeah, there are two ways basically to get onto this path. Like obviously there is going to be more connections in a later stage, but this is the first area that we are working on. Now, it did not really connect the two areas yet. So with the black-tailed prairie dog with the path and this area, so that is still open because I'm still trying to see like how can I make it all blend in nicely to each other. So yeah, I did not fill that particular part in yet. You also not really see that at the cinematic shots in the end. So yeah, after that we will be laying out some fences with some rocks, and I will definitely be using the same technique as we did with the African logs at the prairie dog habitat, because that just looked so amazing. So I really do love to use that again in this area. And we will definitely also be using these African logs more as fences on the edge of the path. And later we will also be adding like these chain link fences, and I will be decorating those as well with the African logs. So we are using a lot of the African logs, but I feel like it's all in a different way as what we normally did. So it feels new to me, even though maybe I'm just forgetting about something, but I don't really think so. But I think it just looks really nice, especially for this more natural area around this habitat. So at the bridge side, I actually decided to use more of the dams that we also used in the beaver habitat. So they are not made by me. They are made by Frontier for the time scenario, and I just blueprinted them because it's a lot easier than putting down all these logs and stuff yourself. So not that I'm really planning on adding a beaver in this habitat, but as I mentioned earlier, like we will definitely give the feeling that there are just beavers living around the whole zoo in the wild, even though now that I think of it, maybe it is a nice idea to just add like maybe one or two beavers in this habitat as well. But we will definitely be adding beavers around this whole North American area as well, more feeling like they are living in the wild. I'm not really sure. Do you guys feel like we should just add one or two beavers in this habitat already, giving the feeling that they probably built that dam or anything like that? Do let me know in the comments down below. But yeah, I just really do love the messy and natural vibe we have going on with these dams. So it just looks super nice putting these around through your habitat and having it more obvious around the bridge. I just really love how that is looking. So as I mentioned in my earlier videos, I don't want this North America region to include snow since we already have the land of the cold area, which is basically all the habitats, including snow. So this is definitely going to be a lot different, more foresty, but I do really think that some habitats for certain animals will probably look a lot different still. So yeah, we're just gonna play around with that, but it's definitely going to be a little bit more foresty, more North American vibe going on here in this area without that much snow. I don't think we're going to add any snow, but maybe I will change my mind a little bit later on, depending on what kind of animal I'm working with. But yeah, we just have to wait and see, I guess. So as I said, like the trees and bushes that I'm going to use around the whole habitat are mostly from North America. I think they're all from North America, from the taiga biome. And for some more contrast, I will be using the Kwakin aspen tree. Hopefully I pronounced that right, which has this beautiful yellow color. And I think that just gives that really nice extra touch and contrast for the whole area. But we're also going to later add some of the purple flowers in the habitat. Like not too many, but they definitely just give that little nice and extra colorful touch as well in the habitat. So I do really love that. Now for the animals, I also really wanted to make some kind of small little cabin with some stables just to give them some shelter for some rain and snow if they like to. I'm not really sure if they will actually be using them, but I can see them just getting some more privacy maybe and just go into their little shelter just to take a nap, or maybe a mommy when she's going to give birth or anything like that. I think it's just really nice to give them a little shelter building in this area. And for the guest, they will also be able to look into this building from a little window on the path side, so they will be able to look inside if there are any mooses just chilling, sleeping, or whatever they're doing inside. So throughout the rest of the habitat, I obviously use a lot of the aquatic rocks in both the taiga and the tundra colors. This actually took so much of my time. Like I really wanted to upload this video already yesterday, but I was at some point just so bored with like putting down all these aquatic rocks and the little details and stuff. So I was like, just so done with it. And I did not add everything in this footage, but it was definitely worth it. But yeah, that is why it took me another day to finish up this habitat for you guys. But it was definitely worth it. Like despite it being a lot of work with the small little details, I really do am super happy with how this habitat has turned out. Now, obviously, like everything you will see in the cinematic shots around the whole habitat looks still very open and plain. But that is just because we don't really have that many habitats still around this area. So it's definitely going to change along the way when we're going to add more and more of these North American animals around this area. And I think it definitely is going to look really amazing once it is all done. So despite having like this whole lake around this area, I'm definitely also planning to play around more with like raised terrain and stuff for some habitats. So maybe we can also play around a little bit with like making waterfalls and stuff ending up more inside of this lake from a higher terrain. Something like that could definitely work out. But yeah, we just have to wait and see, I guess, how this will all end up in the end, depending on what kind of animals we're going to add and depending on what kind of ideas I have. But these are just some thoughts that I have that I don't want everything to be completely flat. So we're definitely also going to play around with like waterfalls and stuff and maybe really different height elevations. That is definitely something I have in my mind. But yeah, I'm very happy to have the moose right now in our city zoo. I think it looks absolutely beautiful with the South American dome in the background. Like you see the sun shimmering on the roof in the background of this habitat. I think that looks absolutely beautiful. And overall, the habitat just looks absolutely stunning with the lighting and stuff. I'm really happy with how this is looking. The one downside that I have to mention is, like, if you see the cinematic shots, like, almost in every shot, the Muses are all swimming around. Like, I don't know if that feels, like, super realistic that they're always swimming, but maybe it was just a coincidence. If I would have waited, then they would be just all on land. But I don't know. They just decided to all go and have a swim around the habitat, I guess. But hopefully in the future, we will see them more just walking around through the trees and stuff. I think that's going to look absolutely beautiful in the end. But yeah, do let me know in the comments down below what you guys think of this moose habitat that we built with the North America pack. Leave a like at the video if you guys enjoyed, and subscribe, of course, if you haven't already. And if you want to see more Planet Zoo content, I definitely have you covered on the channel. Let me know what new North American animal you would like to see in the next episode. And who knows, I might be building a habitat for that animal in the next one. I really look forward to reading all your comments, and if you have any cool ideas or suggestions, do let me know in the comments as well. Thank you guys so much for watching. I really hope to see you guys all in the next one. Bye guys!